because it says it's like the kingdom of God. So I will liken it to the kingdom of God, where the king extended this invitation several times. And to us, it's about the kingdom of God, where his invitation to us. And on this, I've put about 3 points that we can look at. And the first point is about the invitation to eternal life. Invitation of the king, as we have looked at, he invited 3 times he was sending. And now when I come to liken it to the invitation to the kingdom of God, to eternal life, God normally has sent invitations to us just to prepare us for that eternal life. And even the invitation, it's not only once that God will speak to us through the men and women of God. Lesa ala tumobu itekuli ifwe, mubantu aba psana psana, ali pekanya bashima pepo, ala pekanya malay preachers, ala pekanya bantu aba psana psana, ukwisa mkutu pekanya ifwe, uku twitter, kumwe owamu ya yaya. And then, how do we respond to these invitations? How do we respond to the messages that we receive? And sometimes these messages, we come across them in various ways. Nishle shingi esho tupokele ramo ubuite. Limo fweba motu apokele ni ubuite. Limbina wika lafie olo wakumanyo omuntu akweba ko pad message. Akweba ko pabuite wakwa lesa wayangu kirwa waumfwa. Limo ubuite tulakumanya. Sometimes we've seen when we are traveling in the buses, people will come, somebody will be preaching, limbi ani na bus, afuma pa intercity, aleko nka bus kukabangwe. And a lot of times, these men and women of God that bring us this invitation, they go through a lot of scorn. Muli basi, you'd hear comments, because this person has got onto a bus. Paka wangwe, him to come back. Normally, a hand of fellowship will be extended. You donate the money, and there has been scorns of him. Nimpia fiale fwaya. Ero na mumu mwane fia fwele ulia wine. Na kasapatu waka apwa. Na mumu mwana ero alepe na ulia. Aleba kwa chale furungana. Kuchani na muli bus, but he expects you to extend that hand of fellowship so that he gets back to intercity. That person is evangelizing. He's bringing the word of God to us. So he has to get back to intercity by bus, by you helping him with transport. But we criticize them a lot. And for the past Sundays, I think the parable has been coming out. The last time we had the parable of the tenants of the vineyard. When he sent the people, he sent to come and get the harvest, they were killed, they were beaten. It's the same issue with this king who had sent the people. Even now, many of the men and women of God that stand before us to give us the word, to preach to us the invitation to eternal life, we also have a lot of criticism around them. Sometimes we won't even concentrate on the message that the person is giving, but we just center our focus on criticism, on looking at that person. But yeah, so those are the servants of God that normally come to us to bring that invitation to eternal life. And it also matters how we respond, how we treat them, how we react to that message. So that's about the invitation to eternal life, how it comes to us, and how at times we receive that, and whatever excuses we have not to heed this invitation. My second point is about accepting his invitation. When we receive the invitation, our response is to accept. But when we look at the invitation that the king had done, the people had rejected that invitation. All the invitation that was sent, it was rejected. So in our case, we'll look at what is the basic sign of showing acceptance. In our case, the basic sign ichilangililo echo twakwete ifwero twapokere lyo bwite imwe na ine twali umfwiryo bwite mukusumi na kwesu. I think efyo twasangwa pamo efyo twasangwa pamo ngo bwananyina pano percent Matthew, we are here as a point that we accepted that invitation that God sent, the invitation of eternal life. That is the best, the basic of it. But again, that acceptance to you and me, of course, it comes with a cost or a sacrifice. It's not just a matter of accepting that invitation and then we come here and we say, okay, we have accepted. It comes with a sacrifice. And in the letter to the Philippians, Paul is encouraging. Is encouraging us to stay true to the Lord. Is encouraging us to lead a life worth of our acceptance. A life that will really show that the invitation was a call to us by staying to God and requiring a Christian outlook, requiring us to live a life that is full of, to live a life that will portray the image of Christ, to live a life that will indeed uplift someone. Ero tuapokele lobu iteifo tuwaisa pano, kulaba ukuchita sacrifice, ukuikalo uikalo, ubobu lelinga, ubuaku mono kwebati, munchende ino tuwaisa, ninchende ia kwebati, tuwaisa abantu aba kwebati, na tuishi mecho tuishile muno, tuleikala umweo wabu ina Kristu, uwa kutilelio umbiuli kunse, amono umweo inende ikala, ne ufuidi obu ite, na ala ba encouraged, afuidi okumona efyo imamule ikala mwebali muno, efyo mwapo kelelo obu ite. That's the only way that we can also encourage others, those that are yet to listen and accept the invitation. We have to have a lot of control over ourselves. We need to know the persuasions or the negative effects that we can have as we come here, because the negatives of course are a lot. A lot wapokele lobu ite kula befingi ifya lalenga kabidi ukutila ifwe fitusungushe limbielo waisa Saint Matthew ziwe wamo na awa Saint Matthew zimi pepele ine shiite menwe awa Saint Matthew. You start going from place to place, meaning you've not had the maturity of what you have accepted. Because wherever you are, konseko tukaba, ubu itengana tubupokelela, the word of God comes to us in the same way. It just depends on how I take it upon myself, how the maturity of my life is, how the walk that I've decided to take, it's about me. It's not about how the word comes, but it's about me to take up the challenges that comes with what I have accepted through that invitation. So that's about the acceptance of where I want to be after heeding to the invitation. My third point, I looked at our Christian life and Christian journey. I looked at the invitation, back to the invitation, the people that were invited when they didn't come, the king had sent to say, kaleten ifye bonse kaleten. And in this crowd, aishle monamo yumuntu ushafwele ikoti befitting the presence, befitting ubwite bwamfumu. No mbanga mwa ingini la mo, I was pondering, these people were out in the streets. Nomba uyu umofye nge wa sangiro kwe bati ena tafwele chakufwala ichalinga ubwite bwamfumu. Ababa mbibonse badi mu street. So it just depicts that when they heard the calling, they went and prepared themselves. So this is about preparation. They went and prepared themselves and came in the clothing befitting ubuite ebo babita. This one person, for me, I will take it well, maybe he ignored, he had some arrogance, because when the king asked, he didn't say, takwete excuse ya kwewa ati ine, efyo naishi na mufi ya kufuala nifi, he was just quiet. We are talking about ourselves. Ero twaizi tufowite, we are in here, na tuisa pano kukudia kwa mfumu, na tuisa muno munganda ya mfumu, in this house of God where we are. For us to be here, we heeded the invitation and we accepted and we came prepared. Or are we prepared? What coat are we wearing? Tuchine na tufuale koti, lidiani netuwa fuele kudiaba tusangile. And that is the point where we usually look at us not appreciating the unmerited favor of God for us to bring us here. Na tuisa muno munganda, na batubuza, na tuisa. So tuishile mumsangoshi. Are we like this person? Ushe tuishile ngo yumuntu walela anda. Eru aisa fye munganda. Aka nokufula ifya kufuala fidya. Aka nokufule ifya kufuala. Ukuchafuale ifya kufuala. Ifini ingine ukuisa munganda ya mfumo. What are we talking about as we come here? Have we also taken off that coat? That coat, to Paul, he was depicting the two women that were always quarreling. So na ifwebe ne yo koti tufuili yo kufula, ukufuala, ifiringili yo kutitwe muno munganda. It's our attitude. It's our character. It is our behavior. We need to take off and shake off all that cloth that will still have the outer appearance of where we were before. Tufuili okufula, tuafuala ikoti ili ningine ukuti tuikale muno. Ili le tusuminisho ukuti tuikale muno. So iliwe koti efya tufuili okufula. Paul was talking about hard-heartedness and forgiveness, bickering and reconciliation. Kula baba ntuaba kweba tepo mwaya ambiro kubachita reconcile. They will not heed that. They will not reconcile with that. All those differences, that is what that court is representing, which we can't take off even when we are here. So like the master says, like the king did, the owner of the feast, here the owner of the feast is our Lord Jesus Christ. So look at ourselves. I've come all the way, coming to accept the invitation and coming in here to join the family of St. Matthew's. Nchirini mfuala umutima uachpiu. Nchirini mfuala uakuma no umutima. Nchirini mfuala unforgiveness. Nchirini mfuala bitterness. So when the Lord comes, when the owner of the feast iine fitulimo, ubu ichobu tulimu ama lilo ya mfumu, akesa, akese nsanga inene, kochi niliyali ine, akale kukunsobolola, akale kukumfumia, paba nandi ukweba tiwe kwena, all the commitment that you've had, all the works that you've had, all the things, the hard work that you've had in this feasting house, you didn't take off the coat. Tawafuele chakufuala, ichakulingo kuikala pali inchende. Meaning, you did not shed off your old self, where the Lord picked you with his unmerited grace to bring you in here. You can be in here, yes, but look at what coat you are wearing. Are you still wearing this coat? Muchinina mufuala na imwena ine. Tuchinina tufuale lini ine coat. Oh, have we decided to put in a coat? Tufuale ikoti ini ningiri okulikala muno. Where we are here, where we are depicting Christ, are we in that coat? We decided which of it that we need to check ourselves to say, likoti shimfuele. Uche mfuele koti ya kweba tinga ba isaine bakesa mfumia pano pama lila ya ba Yesu. In this house of the Lord, where the Son dwells, where the Lord dwells, will I be taken out? Will I be pulled out of, have I changed my character? Have I dropped off those attitudes? Have I now taken up the image of Christ as I dwell in the presence of God? Elionjikele muno muma lila ya kwalesa ayamu anawa mfumu. Ushaine njipesa mfwele kotishi. That is the preparedness that we have to look ourselves and check our lives as we indeed want to be in the family of this Christian life where we need to take up a new character. We need to take up a new attitude, a new behavior about ourselves, a behavior and character that will portray Christ about our lives, that will portray Christ about our walk in this Christian walk. And finally, in conclusion, like Paul was saying, I also would like to encourage us, to encourage ourselves to say, let us put our thoughts, let us focus our thoughts on the things that will uplift Christ, on the things that will indeed show that we are a changed generation, that we are a people who really want to be in the presence, in the feast of the Lord, shedding off all the attitude, shedding off the old coat. And with this, all what is required is obedience. The obedience, the word obedience, once it comes above you, it will not be difficult just to adhere to what is required for us to be in this feast of the Lord. And that obedience, Paul encourages us to say, that obedience comes with prayer and supplication in our faith, all the time with prayer and supplication in our faith. Because God's invitation is always there. God will never give up in inviting us. Le satana koku twitter. God is always bringing the word to us. God is always uplifting us. He's always inviting us. His invitations are endless. Just like the king, his invitations were endless. So let us endeavor to heed the invitation and then accept it and change our court, change our attitude. Because this time, this privilege that we have, we may not have it. There may not be that time of God again coming to say, kabete ni bonse nomba, bese bengide, bese bavariye mufisti. And we may not have that chance, my sisters and brothers, my fellow aunties, my fellow grannies. This chance, we may not have it again. We've been given this chance so that we may utilize it. Let us use it accordingly and wisely. We need to use it wisely because, as I've said, this banquet will never have that chance to come in a banquet where we'll just be called and say, can you all come and enjoy the feast? We have the opportunity, we have the privilege. So can we utilize that? Can we use that? That's the sharing for today. May his word be praised. Amen.